Live in HD from the station that brings you more West Texas news. News West 9 at 6 starts now.
New at 6 tonight, we all know traffic has exploded in the tall city, but now an online petition has been started to do something about it.
But the proposed answer to the problem can't exactly be called a safe idea. Our Gina Martinez joins us now live from Loop 250 in Midland to tell you what petition organizers are trying to do. Gina?
Crystal and Mike, we're here off of Loop 250 and Wadley in Midland. And if you look behind me, you can see the traffic is moving pretty steadily. It's not too congested right now, but some days it is. And, you know, you've seen it before that these people, the lines get backed up here on the yield signs. Well, one person online created a website, and they think there's an easy fix to ease up all of this congestion. They think it's getting rid of what's right behind me, the yield sign. So imagine that. The Loop 250 without any yield signs. That's their quick fix idea, but it has a lot of people wondering, is this the right thing to do?
It's crazy out there. I try to avoid it at all costs between 5-6:30.
Rush hour traffic on Loop 250 in Midland isn't anything new. With more people flocking to the tall city for work, traffic gets heavy, potentially causing more accidents. But an online petitioner believes this is part of the problem, the yield sign. The website is called noyieldmidland.com. There's no word on who created the petition, but whoever did says the red triangle causes congestion on the service roads.
Initially, years ago, it was stop signs, and I believe they were on the ramps.
But transportation manager Gary Saunders says that created backup traffic, so yield signs were put up instead. The website says the constant flow of exiting traffic leaves drivers waiting for a break for long periods of time.
With so many people these days, it's almost impossible to get where you need to be if you are yielding.
It goes on to say drivers are then left to take the risk of going ahead despite oncoming traffic and hope for the best. It also points out another issue drivers may face.
No one really even pays attention to yield signs anymore, so I'm real cautious when I come up on one.
They just keep going, and those people keep going, and they honk, and they, you know.
So the answer? Do away with them altogether. The petitioner writes, drivers in both lanes should take caution by using their blinkers and checking to make sure the area is clear. But Saunders disagrees.
I'd rather see something there than nothing. If you remove it, that really creates an intersection that's uncontrolled.
We spoke with several drivers who felt the same way.
They just need to leave them there and people need to obey them.
I don't think people really pay attention to other people's blinkers all that much.
I don't really think it's a good idea. I think the only solution would be for them to modify the roads.
Saunders says that's up to TxDOT and funding is an issue, but he feels it's safer to have something better than nothing at all.
Now, Crystal and Mike, that online petition has only gained about a dozen signatures so far, so not too many just yet, but obviously whoever created it is hoping it'll get a lot more. If you'd like to sign that petition, you can go to noyieldmidland.com. For now, reporting live in Midland, Gina Martinez, News West 9.